Hello everyone, this is Justin from Justin's Orchids and More. I hope everybody's having a good day. If you're a new subscriber, welcome to my channel. I like to grow orchids and different plants, and I just have different videos on doing different things. I've got a greenhouse that I'm building right now, and I've been trying to make some videos on that, and different videos on house plants, and I've got this raised garden that I've really been getting interested in lately. It's been doing better. The video's coming soon. We'll see how those herbs and stuff are doing in my tomato plants. But I haven't done a little repot video in a little while. Now I know all my orchid followers out there probably aren't going to be in this video too much. This is today we're going to be repotting a Hoya. But I'll tell you what, I've been looking at the plant, and this is Hoya Chelsea. Now I'll put a picture up of what the blooms look like. When I was in Colombia about maybe a month, I don't know, maybe a month, month and a half ago for a checkup when I had my surgery done on my thumb, I found this place in Colombia that actually has some orchids and it has some Hoya plants. It's called Jared's Jungle. And I bought this Hoya for $25. You can still see it right there. And this was just a cutting that, they took about three or four leaves and cut the stem off, put it in some soil, and, there it went. And I've been looking at it, and you know what? Let's just look at the plant. Like, it deserves a repot. I mean, it's doing so well for a cutting, okay? But, look at this new shoot right here. Look at that. Look at these roots. So, that's growing. There's one point of growth. Here's another point of growth right here. It's doing good. These leaves, man, look how nice these leaves look. There's one, and here's one. So there's 3 points of growth, and the Hoya's just looking good. And it deserves a repot. And I thought, I'm not really gonna do anything special. I know everybody that probably watches this channel knows how to repot plants. I just kind of share it with you guys. Let's take a look at it, because I really want to see what the root system looks like. That's what I'm curious about. I want to know, how good is this root system? And I have not disturbed this plant one bit, and I'm going to be easy with it. But yes, that's a good looking root system for a Hoya. And if you have Hoyas out there and you want to do repots, I'm gonna tell you something. When you pull off a pot off of a plant like that, and these roots look this good, don't mess with the soil. Don't break it up. Don't mess with it. Leave it just like it is right now. Don't disturb it. If you start pushing this soil out, you're gonna set this plant back. It's gonna go into shock. It's gonna take a little while to recover. This plant is not pot bound yet. And, here's a lesson for house plants. This isn't pot bound yet. Okay. Now if there was an issue with mold or something going on where I had to clean out the soil, that'd be another case, that'd be something different. But when it looks this good right here, don't mess with it. Look at that. Don't that look nice? This is a healthy little plant, and I like that. That's good. I got, that plant was well worth $25 to me. So what I'm gonna do is I've got some Miracle-Gro potting mix. I use this for all my house plants. It has a little bit of feed in it, a little bit of perlite. It's good stuff. And I'm going to be going from this pot to this pot. And I've, this is used pot. I've tried to clean it off good, but that's what we're gonna be using. And so what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna move the Hoya Chelsea over here. I'm just gonna take some of this soil. And when you're trying to choose a size pot to pot up to when you're potting up, let's say, like you're going from a pot like this here, to a pot this size. Now if we're talking about growing orchids, that's just way too big in my opinion. But with house plants and stuff. I've chosen this size pot, and I'll put them side by side so y'all can see the difference in the, you know, in the size of the pots. But I won't have to worry about it for a little while in this pot, and I can just let it go. You know, just water it, feed it, let it go, and it'll be in here for at least 6 months. You know, maybe longer than that. Depends on how the plant goes. But so far, what I'm doing, I'm just, you know, putting my soil in there, and I'm pushing it up on the sides, just like that, pushing it up on the sides. And I want to get a little bit more because, you know, I'm looking at the root ball over there. So I'm just kind of pushing it on the sides like so. That. And I like that. That's what I'm going to use. And then I got a little bit left to put around the sides. So I'm just going to take my plant and I'm going to put it right in the center. Let's see. I think that's a good level right there. I'm looking at it. Right there in the center. And let me get where I'm in the camera so it doesn't make such a damn mess. Let's do it like this. But yeah, like I was saying, I hope everybody's having a good day. The greenhouse is coming along. I haven't been able to work on it a whole lot lately because I've been so busy starting to move furniture and stuff. So I'm actually at a part where I'm trying to get the roof done and I need some help. And I'm going to ask there's a guy that lives next door. I'm going to ask him tomorrow if he'll come over and give me a hand because I'm starting to do the roof part of that greenhouse. And I need another set of hands on the other side when I'm trying to put up that longest piece at the arch at the top. But I'll be sure to give you guys updates on that. And I do have some orchids that are coming into bloom soon. I think my friend Preston, a couple of his Phalaenopsis orchids that he gave me are getting ready to open up. And I'll be sure to show those, Preston. Thank you again, by the way. I think I'm gonna do a video tomorrow on the raised bed, the herb garden, because I think it's looking, we had about 2 days of rain here, and it's really looking good. Well, it's looking good. I wouldn't say really looking good, but tomato plants look good. Anyway, so let's look at the Hoya. This is the repot. You know, this is gonna weigh down eventually and finally come down this way. And what I'll eventually do is put hangers on this. And this is going to be a hanging plant. We're going to hang it, you know. And in my new greenhouse, I have got plenty of room at the ceiling. This greenhouse has a very high ceiling for me anyway, from what I'm used to. So I'm going to be able to hang a lot of plants. And this is going to be one that will be hanging. And, you know, maybe eventually we'll get to see some blooms off this Hoya Chelsea. But anyway, guys, I just wanted to make out a little video and kind of show you guys what I would do to plant this Hoya. Plant looks good. Anyway, I hope everybody enjoys the video. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. And I'll see you on the next one.